Xcode can offer huge potential to any developer to find massive success. But in order to do that, developers like you need to stay ahead of the curve. It is essential that you work not just harder, but smarter and faster. So to help you succeed today, I'm going to give you 30 Xcode shortcuts that you want to use on a daily basis. And don't forget to check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call if you want to chat about SwiftUI or learn about SwiftUI, or if you have any bugs in your code, go ahead and check it out. I can help you out. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, today we are going to talk about Xcode shortcuts, and I have prepared here a demo project. Well, it is a vanilla project, but I have added a test field there. That's just it. We are going to take a look at why I added that on a later shortcut. Go ahead and check out all of the 30 Xcode shortcuts. There will be timestamps down below, or if you want to go ahead and check out the description for those. And make sure that you watch till the end, because we are going to have 4 bonus Xcode tips. So, shortcut tips. So, first one is building the project. So that is Command B. If we hit Command B, the build will just start, and Xcode will build our project. And as you can see, so the build has completed. Now, another one is running the project. Now, it's building and running. So that is Command R. So build has succeeded and is also going to run this on the simulator, which is really great. Now, the next step is if you want to clean your build folder. Sometimes it's going to get a little bit messy, and maybe the project will not build, or we are going to have some errors. Then you can clean your builds folder, and that is Shift Command K. So Shift Command K, and that is going to clean your build folder. Now, another one, number 5, is open quickly. This is one of my favorites, and that is Command Shift O. So Command Shift O, there we go. We can open quickly maybe our assets or whatever. You know, we can search here for also our body, you know. All the functions and all the files can be searched right over here. It's really, really great. Now, another good one is Shift Command Shift L, and that is going to open up our library. You can see currently I'm at the system symbols, but we can have also our buttons, our you know, controls, snippets. So it's going to open up our library. We can search through that. It's really, really amazing. Again, Command Shift L. Now, one a good thing that I really like about Xcode is that we can have kind of these shortcuts. Again, shortcut to our previews, our body. If we just click on that, it's just going to jump right over here. Let's just go to the preview. But how do we open this up automatically? Well, that is Control 6. I know it's a little bit encrypted, Control 6, but if you just hit Control 6 and then you would move with the up and down arrows. Also, you can just type in a query and then you can search through all of those functions, properties that you have in this file. So it's really, really great. Now, one other thing is that you could just fold all the methods, and that is number 8, Shift Option Command and backward. So Shift Command Option backward. There we go. It's going to fold all of our methods. Now the unfold is Shift Command Option and forward arrow. Again, backwards and forwards. Of course, if you could just double click on it, it's just going to expand on that, just like that. So this time we are going to fold all of our functions, methods. Now we can just fold in scope. Let's just say I want to fold this scope. So that would be Command Option. So we without the shift. So just Command Option and then backward. So now this V stack is just folded, or you just go with the forward arrow. You can just go for unfolding it. Now that's for folding, unfolding in scope and all of our methods. Next one is to open up a new tab, and that is Command T. And what that will do is just open up a new tab. It's just, you know, you can just have multiple tabs right over here. Then you can just move around, maybe just go also to the assets. And you can just work on those tabs. Really, really powerful because, yeah, now you just have multiple tabs. Okay, so what if we want to close our tabs? We just go Option Command W. As you can see, everything has been closed but the current assets tab. Of course, we can just go ahead and click on those exits also. Now, what if I want to move some lines? This is really, really amazing. Now, let's say I want to move this padding all the way to the text field. And that is Command Option and then open and close square brackets. So we can just go with the open square bracket or the closing square bracket. Now, of course, this works with multiple lines also. In our case, it's just really gibberish, but we don't really need to do that. But you can do that also. Again, moving lines upward and downward, it's Command Option and opening or closing square brackets. Now, how do we hide the console? Currently, you can see that we have our console opened up. We can do that with Shift Command Y. So Shift Command Y, it's just going to hide it, or hitting Shift Command Y again is just going to open it up. You know, the console is always popping up. You want to have a shortcut for that. Now, how do we comment or uncomment stuff? Let me just see if I want to comment this out. We just go Command forward slash, and it's just going to do that. We can just do this on multiple lines, of course, if we want to. Let's just revert back that, or you could just have not the Command C, but Command forward slash 2, also uncomment it. So it's commenting and uncommenting. So how would we go about the navigator? It would be Command 0. It's just going to hide and unhide the navigator. Now, this is really nice, but there's also Command 1, 2, let's just go back to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's just going to go through all of the elements of our navigator. This is really, really great. Now, what if I want to do the same thing with the inspector on the right? Now, we could just go Option Command 0. It's just going to hide all of that. It's really nice. And then Option Command 1, 2, 3, 4. It's really, really amazing. As you can see, we can just jump through all of those with just the simple shortcuts of 1 and, you know, the numerics. Okay, now, how do we find something? Here in my file, in the content view, I just hit Command F. The finder will just pop up and I can just search for, I don't know, text. And there we go. We have our text highlighted. Now, how do I jump to the next one? And that is Command G. As you can see, just jumping through the next. Okay, and how do I jump to the previous? And that is Shift Command G. It's just going to go backward, which is really, really amazing. Now, this is local finding. What if I want to search, like find globally? And that is Command Shift F. And it's just going to open this up. This is much more powerful. You can just go containing, matching words, and all of that, ignoring cases. Yeah, you can just go ahead and find throughout your project globally. Now, what if I want to indent, or maybe I just mess this up. Let me just have it a little bit here. Let's just add a few more there, a few more spaces. Now, this doesn't look really nice, right? So what I can do is just select one line and hit Control-I, and that will indent this automatically. Or I could just select everything that I want to indent and hit Control-I there. Let me just move that back. Usually I would just go Command-A to select everything and then Control-I to have that indented. As you can see, now it's really, really nice. Now, what if I wanted to add some inline documentation? Let's say this text. That's Option Command and forward slash. Now, currently it's just a description, but if it were a function or with some properties, then it would be highlighted. If it's going to return something, then it's going to give that document, the inline documentation, really, really nicely. Okay, so one thing you know that I don't really like is the canvas in Swift UI. And the first thing that I do is just hide it. Now, there's a keyboard shortcut for that, and that is Option Command and Return. As you can see now, it's just jumping it off. Option Command Return is just going to bring it back again, which is really nice. So what I'm going to do is just leave it at that. We are going to hide it. One thing that Xcode has is a minimap. I rarely use it, but you can turn it on and off with a simple shortcut, and that is Option Command Shift M. And you can see now it's just loading it. Option Command Shift M will just unhide it, just like that. If you like the minimap, you can just go ahead and use it. Now, those were the 30 Xcode shortcuts that I highly recommend that you use, and now here comes 4 bonuses. And the first three are regarding to our simulator. And the first one is the simulator size. Now, if you hit while the simulator is open, you hit Command 1 or 2, you can just jump through all of the sizes that you have right over there. And also, you can set up the orientation with Command and then forward arrow or backwards arrow. You know, you can just move that around with the arrows. Now, there's also a keyboard shortcut for the simulator. If I click on here, as you can see, it's just bumping it up because I have selected Command K. Command K will just show and hide. Most probably, if you have just started out your simulator, it will not just pop up automatically. Command K is how you show the keyboard on the simulator. And finally, one of my favorites is multiple inserts. Let's say if I wanted to have, many state variables, I would just have here 3 lines, and then I would just hold Option and then just drag down right over there and just add state private var, let's just go for name equals and an empty string there, and then I could just click right over here, let that be 0, 1 and 2, name 2. And if I just decided that, okay, the name isn't what I actually wanted to give, then again, Option and then just drag, Option and drag the whole name. And just lift your finger, the selection, and then the Option, and then you could just go text. And there we go, we just renamed all of that. Now, learning all of these Xcode shortcuts is a really good habit to have. And if you want to learn more about developer habits, go ahead and check out my video on that. It's right over here.